Hi kids, so I'm going to show you how to do some melted crayon art with something called a warming tray. First thing you want to do with your warming tray is you want to lay down some aluminum foil over top of it so that you don't get wax on your warming tray. So this is just a warming tray that you would normally use to keep food warm. And I actually found it for $2.50 at a thrift store. So you might be able to find one at a thrift store as well. You can also find them online, but they're much more expensive, brand new online. I think they range from anywhere from like 20 to 40 bucks online. You could also see if your family wants to try to find one used on Craigslist or some other app that has used goods. So I'm gonna show you a couple different things. So you just need regular printer paper for this and some crayons, okay? And I'm just gonna use a bunch of old crayons because you don't need anything fancy. One thing you will notice though is cheaper crayons don't work as nicely as some of the more expensive crayons. I found that the Rose Art and the Crazy Art crayons are not, the pigment or the color in the crayon is not as intense as the Crayola crayons when you melt them, but they still definitely work, okay? So I've got a Crayola crayon here. I've got a couple of them. You might need to peel the crayon a little bit because the crayon will melt as you draw. One thing you're gonna wanna be careful about is the warming tray does get pretty hot. So if you leave your hand on the warming tray for a while, it is going to burn. If you just gently touch it, it's fine, okay? So like if I go like this, I can feel the heat, but it doesn't hurt. But if I leave my hand on here for an extended period of time, it's really gonna hurt, okay? All right, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my crayon and I'm gonna start drawing. Now, what you're gonna notice when and if you do this is that the crayon just simply melts as you draw with it on the warming tray, okay? So this is a cheaper Crazy Art crayon, and what I've noticed with the Crazy Art crayons is you can see that they have more wax and less pigment in them because they kind of get these little spots around them that it's just extra wax. Now I'm gonna show you what it's like when you draw with a Crayola crayon. Okay, you get cleaner lines, more intense color because there's more pigment and less wax. Okay, so if I draw just a simple oval with the Crayola, I don't get that same melted effect as I do with the Crazy Art. So like here, the Crazy Art has all this like extra wax, and here's the Crayola. Okay, but this is incredibly satisfying to do. It's very smooth and creamy as you feel the crayon melt with each stroke of your hand. And so it kind of feels like you're painting and drawing at the same time, which is a really neat feeling. It also kind of makes the crayon almost feel like an oil pastel because it glides so smoothly against the surface, okay? You can roll crayons on their side to do this to fill in large areas. It is harder to do like smaller details with this process because, you know, you're using crayons and they're melting. So even if you have a fine tip crayon, it's gonna melt and be thicker as you work, okay? So Look what happened to this crayon in that short amount of time. It's just a little sliver now, okay? So one other thing you can do with this process is the wax is going to soak through the paper, and you can actually lay paper on top of the soaked through wax and create another design. So I'm just gonna kind of go crazy adding color to this to try to get the wax to build up and soak through the paper. Because then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use that leftover wax that's sitting on top of the aluminum foil to create a mono print, which is one print, okay? Right now, what I'm doing with the crayon, you know, it might look like scribbling, but what I'm doing is I'm doing a circular motion with the crayons, which is actually called, does anyone remember? It's called scumbling. So I am scumbling with the crayon, okay? All right, let's see how much wax we have. We have quite a bit of wax, but not the variety of colors that I want. So let me try a little bit more with some other colors. Really building this wax up now. Okay, got a little bit more there. So maybe I'll actually flip it. Okay, so now I've got some nice hot waxy crayon on my aluminum foil. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my paper and I'm gonna lay it on top of the melted wax, just like so. And I'm gonna very gently with my fingers, or you could also use a pencil, okay? I'm gonna transfer the wax to paper, okay? And then I end up with a print, okay? So this is the one I ended up with earlier. And this is the one I ended up with now. Now, this is a great way to make backgrounds for art, or even to make collage paper for art. And the cool thing about this big waxy piece of paper that I just made is that you can actually feel a nice thick layer of wax on both sides. And I am going to use this for collage. I think this would make fabulous collage paper. So I'm going to cut out different shapes, glue them together, and create some sort of image. Otherwise, if you want to make an actual design with the melted crayon, you can do that as well. Okay. All right. Remember to be safe. Unplug the device when you're done using it. Don't rest your hands on it. And you may want to do this with an adult. All right. Happy art making.